is probably why most of you guys are here. Very ambitious young man, very funny young man. He's always popping willies though. Please welcome Gabriel Julio Gomez!
Wheelchair from a motorcycle accident. Yep, yep. But most people, they assume that I got shot. Well, I got shot on my motorcycle, which led to the accident. But it was the accident that put me here. Nah, man, I didn't get shot. But my own doctor even assumed I got shot. I went to a new doctor, right? They asked me what happened. And I said, motorcycle accident. Doctor looks down at my files and says, says here you got shot. I was like, that's impossible. I told every doctor I was in a motorcycle accident. Then the doctor shows me my medical files and it said, got shot. Like, maybe I did get shot. But that means that sometime when I seen a doctor and he asked me what happened and I said, motorcycle accident, the doctor looked at me, yeah, I don't believe him, got shot. That's a true story. Yeah, but I seen many a doctor in my day, got many a prescription. But have you ever wanted to try a medication for the side effects? Like, usually side effects are bad, right? Like, this will cure your headache, but may cause rectal bleeding. You're like, good, I don't have a headache no more, but I gotta wear a maxi pad on my booty. Nah, but like, I don't have a problem with sleep, right? I sleep just fine. But I did hear about this medication called Ambien. You guys heard about this? You guys heard about Ambien? Mm-hmm. You guys avid users over here? Any holders? I'm willing to want to try it. No. But okay, what I heard about this medication is a key side effect, right? And it says, may cause sleepwalking. So that got me thinking. I'll let it sink in. Miracle drug. I mean, you never know, right? Maybe one night I should set up some cameras so I know I'm not hallucinating. And I should pop that pill. I mean, maybe my conscious mind is locked up by all these rules of science. But my unconscious mind is like a butterfly tattooed hippie that wants to skip around my apartment in the middle of the night. What, no believers here? Can I get an amen, Life Factory?
Amen!
Hallelujah. Now, I'm no man of great faith, but like the famous philosopher Curtis 50 Cent Jackson said, all I need is a little bit. Oh, what's up, man? It's been a minute since that song came out, yo. Tell me, man, times have changed, games changed. See, I'm 41 now. And I've witnessed the past 20, 30 years of how things have shifted. The past couple years have been pretty wild, actually. In the past couple years, I did a marathon without running. 26.2 miles. Thank you. I jumped out of a plane without jumping. Well, actually, I was more thrown out like a dead body. But I was attached to a live body, you know? I have my land, right? So it all worked out. Published a book without writing one, and I started doing stand-up without the ability to stand up. Some of the famous words of Alanis Morissette said, isn't that ironic, don't you think? Yeah, man, but the game has changed, yo. See, like, I still can remember a time when a girl wrote her phone number on my arm. Yeah, man, and if you're wondering why would a girl write her phone number on your arm, then you never lived in the land of the lost. You know, before GPS, when people got lost 15 minutes away from their house, man, you had to use a Thomas guide back then. And I don't know who this guy Thomas was, but I think he was fucking with us because he never put the pages in order. You know, because like nobody had a cell phone back then. Back then, only doctors and drug dealers had cell phones. My dad had a cell phone. Wasn't raised by a doctor. But anyways, the point I'm making is that the game has changed, right? Times are different. You know, everybody's online dating. Oh, we got a online dater right there for sure. Huh? What dating site are you on, ma'am? No, I personally gave up online dating. It's like, I kept getting annoyed at them making me put my height. I was like, do I put my horizontal height? My vertical height? I mean, it varies. Do I put the height that I used to be? Do I put the height that I'm sitting at? Or should I just put on 6'1"? I mean, the girl's not gonna know the difference anyway. Till she's lying in bed next to me. And by then it's too late. I'm like the Kaiser Soze, man, of comedy, man. I'm just faking this thing until the job is done. Once I become a famous comedian, after my special, I'm just gonna get up and walk away. And poof, I'll be gone. 20-year bit, yeah, man. Now, but people ask if I get nervous up here. I tell them, no, I can't really feel. I mean, it's almost like my nerves are paralyzed. But it is a powerful feeling being up here. Like, I get how the fear of public speaking is like embedded in our DNA for a reason. Because it's not natural to speak to an audience and not be nervous. I mean, it's kind of alien-like. Because you get a certain energy from the crowd. Like being up here, I get how there was a Hitler. I mean, if I learned German, it's game over, yo. There will be a new superior race, one with the dark skin and the blue eyes. And the German wheels. You know, because like all wheelchairs would be made by Mercedes. It'd be like a level of status. Be like, where do you still walk? I got my white slave pushing me around. Yeah, I don't know where to go now after talking about Hitler. But I mean, as far as just public speaking ability, I mean, he's the GOAT, right? I mean, it's either him or Billy Graham. You gotta go one way or another. Me personally, I vote for old Billy. But Google, you know what Google says the greatest public speaker is? Google says it's JFK. But then I thought, but I mean, if your own people whacked you, I don't think they like what you were saying that much. Yeah, man. I'm telling you, yo. So, I'm originally from East Los Angeles, right? Yeah. But in 2020, I moved to Huntington Beach. Because when things started going off the rails and they started shutting everything down, I knew one thing. Follow the white people. And don't get no whiter than Huntington Beach, yo. I'm telling you, they sell sunscreen everywhere. I knew those shelves would stay stocked. Yeah, man. Shoot. You know, I hate when they do the national anthem. Hear me out. Hear me out. I'm patriotic, and I love the words. I just hate how everyone has to stand up. And then I'm left sitting there. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not trying to protest this thing. Getting dirty looks from the guy across the way. Like, you can't see the wheels. I ain't sitting in this thing for my health. Well, I guess I'm technically sitting in for my health, but you know, it's like I took my dog to a vet. I talked my dog to a vet, right? And I don't mean those heroes that fought in the war, but them schizophrenic doctors that think they can understand animals. And see, I took my dog in for what clearly seemed to be an eye infection. The vet comes back with a list full of tests, coming up to over $800. I'm like, what are all these tests for? She's like, well, we gotta find out what it is. I said, well, what do you think it is? She gives me a list of possibilities. First, starting off with cancer. Lastly, stating eye infection. I said, whoa. Look, vet, that never fought in a war. Don't bother looking for cancer. I mean, this cancer, I ain't shelling out 20 grand for this dog's chemo. This was a free dog. And before you think I'm cold-hearted or anything, I love my dog, man. My dog lives a great life. I take her everywhere with me. She's in the trunk right now. I left open no crack. Nah, but my dog is a great life. She's the best food, man. I feed her pizza, chicken, hot dog weenies. Man, I give her a hot dog weenie every night. I tell her the same thing. Come here, Cinnamon. Every good girl gets a weenie. And some nights I'll be like, and really good girls get two weenies. Here you go. Yeah, and I don't believe you have to pick your dog shit up if your dog weighs less than 6 pounds. I don't know, it's what I believe. I also believe you don't have to wear a condom if your dick's bigger than 6 inches, but I'm not saying I'm right, I'm just saying these are thoughts, all right? It's like my dog's a little bigger than a squirrel, right? So I'm like, what do you want me to do, pick up squirrel shit? Like, I look at it like, that ain't even worth a plastic bag. I'm trying to save the earth here, people. Just a little fertilizer for the ground. One less plastic bag in the ocean. And I don't believe you have to pick your dog shit up if it's diarrhea either. I I mean, if it's diarrhea, it's just there, yo. Like, I didn't bring a spatula. I mean, why do you think I'm feeding your piece of chicken, man? I'm trying to keep that shit loose. I ain't never picking that shit up. And if y'all looking at me all bad, and I didn't see the red light, yo. Y'all looking at me mad. Walk a mile in my shoes. Well, I guess that term really don't work for me, because I don't walk a mile in my own shoes. But anyways, my name is Gabriel Gomez, y'all. And I'm a pleasure coming out.